So can you spot a noticeable difference in V-shapes? Or V's? Well, today I'm exploring exactly how much inner wall speed affects the outside print quality, and some results might surprise you. So let's find out more. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. They offer a variety of professional services like PCB prototyping, CNC machining or 3D printing. They also have a PCBWay Plus community where you can find all sorts of electronic projects from enthusiasts around the world. Before, if you're interested, check it out and also get 5 bucks off for your first purchase with a link in the video description. And for those who want to challenge themselves, currently there is an active contest with some nice prizes. The first question when making a comparison is always which test prints to use. From my experience, prints with vertical walls and top-down lighting will show the inconsistent outside layers the most. And I can't stress this enough, the lighting is key here, because with a correct angle you can easily expose or hide the imperfections of the prints. So without further ado, let's go straight to the test print results. And when I checked them under the microscope that AndonStar kindly sent to me for showing you guys better views of these prints, the results looked basically the same. And if you have a lot of experience with 3D printing, I can already hear the correct answer why. So the main reason for that is the 3D printer's acceleration. You see, same as racing on multi-turn tracks, speed is nothing without adequate acceleration. To help you visualize things, this is how printing speeds look with 1k compared to a 3k acceleration value. As you see, even at this low speed, we only manage to maintain 69 nits versus 85% of the set target speed. And if we compare when printing inner walls at twice the speed, the drop is even more drastic. So the first very important point before we start further testing is that the wall speed almost doesn't even matter for most printers on the market when printing very detailed objects. And nope, the prints from the start of the video weren't from these results. Well then, let's increase acceleration to 3k and repeat the prints. And here are the results. The one on the left was printed with 1k acceleration and 30 mm per second for all perimeter walls, and on the right with the same acceleration and speed for the outer wall, but with 3k and 60 mm per second for the inner walls. The difference is subtle, but when you know where to look, it's not very hard to spot it. The increase in speed with this print will result in around 20% lower print times. And I would say these are pretty good results considering that we are running the printer with 3 times higher acceleration than default and stock firmware. So with that in mind, this is how print looks when we use 3k acceleration and 60 mm per second speed on all walls. And now the ghosting and all vibrations are way more pronounced. It will result in further 10% print time reduction, but in my opinion it is not worth it at all if you search for the settings with the fastest print times and minimal quality loss. And what about small object prints, like this Kali Dragon that became one of my favorites? Just keep in mind that at 3k acceleration we actually get the set speeds. But can you spot the difference? Even when I looked at them directly, it was really hard to tell which one is which. The only place that gave it away was this sharp corner that had noticeable ghosting, otherwise there was no difference whatsoever. Another important scenario is the overhangs and angles. For that I made this spaceship looking part with 45, 55 and 65 degree angles. And with this print, even if we would set acceleration to a quite low value like 500, we would still reach the set speeds on the curves. So can you see any difference in this scenario? Well, try to guess for yourself. This is pretty hard one to get right as both parts look extremely similar. So here is the answer on the screen. And I got to say, these are quite impressive results. Also, this speed increase helped us to reduce the print time by around 15%. But this is a small and lightweight printer on linear rails. So what about the worst case scenario? A big printer with a big nozzle, heavy glass bed and palm wheels. Well, the results here are a little bit less impressive. I would say the most spots of the print still looks on par despite the twice faster inner wall speed. The only bad thing is the overhangs in the sharp corner where the seams meet and this low radius corner. But this problem is also amplified because bigger nozzles also bring worse overhangs as Thomas already showed in his recent video. And if you own a larger scale printer, you probably will print bigger things. then it potentially will spend more time at higher speeds. So for that I made this shape with straight walls, overhangs and angles. And just like before, we're seeing worse overhangs at high angles and at sharp corners. But there's so little difference elsewhere, so considering that is close to worst case scenario, I would say it is not bad at all. But what about PTG prints? This time I will use Prusa Style Mega S 3D printer, and here are the results. So do they look any different? Well, not by a lot, there's some ghosting in some corners, but rather than that, both test parts look very similar. Exactly the same I can say about the results of a smaller spaceship prints. And the most important thing to take into account is that we are trying to expose the problems, either with the print files or with the lighting. In a more regular conditions, these imperfections will be way harder to spot with a naked eye. And I left the best for the last, the 90 versus 30mm per second inner wall speed with my final design test part. It incorporates all the most important features from previous designs. Here I was chopping almost 1/3 of a total printing time. And considering that, I would say the results are very acceptable. Yes, there will be prints where you see very little improvements in print time, but there also will be ones that result in huge time cuts. So in summary, how much inner wall speed affects the outside print quality? Well, in most cases not by a lot, and we can get a significant print time reduction. The most visible defect that was most common in all the prints was ghosting in spots where the printer had to slow down very fast and then continue accelerating. Small and light printers will see the most benefit, same with nozzles, as smaller ones will print overhangs more cleanly, especially at high speeds. And the last important thing is the nozzle quality. As I tested in my previous video, the big downside of cheap nozzles was the thermal conductivity. And it's important because the more drastic difference in speed we have, the better heat transfer we must have to get consistent filament temperature. And if we need to crank the printing temperature by 7 degrees even at 30mm per second, it would be hard to imagine what we need for 3 times the printing speed. But as we still need to print the outer wall at a way slower rate, this could lead to a horrible stringing. So this is why the nozzle quality is important in this specific scenario. So yeah, I hope this helped you to see more in depth on this specific topic. And if you liked the video, you know what to do, I won't bother with all the blah blah blah. However, consider becoming a patron, where I post info that didn't fit into these videos, practical printing in my daily life, parametric, fusion and step files and more. It is a great way to support my work and get something in return. Thanks to everyone who supported or still supports the channel. Well, that's all from me, and we'll see you next time.